Hello, hi my dear friends, welcome to my channel HSR Bioinfo. In previous sessions we have studied the cell biology concepts like differences between the plant and animal cells and also differences between the eukaryotes and prokaryotes. In today's class we are going to see an important topic, that is the membrane of the cell. So, we know very well the cell that contains the outer surface, that is called as the cell membrane. Already we have discussed in the previous classes. That cell membrane, actually it is a fluid structure. And it's a dynamic. And allows the selective permeability. So, it is a fluid in nature and it has different functions, that's why it's called as a dynamic nature, and also it permeates only few selective molecules across the plasma membrane, that's why called as it is a selective permeability. So, this is all about the plasma membrane of any cell. Different types of animals are there, we know very well, all the animal cells and plant cells that contains the similar type of the plasma membrane. But these plasma membrane majorly that contains the lipids and proteins. So, these lipid and protein contents may vary from the animals to the animal. Let us see the RBC cells. RBC cell is a model for the plasma membrane. So, this RBC cell actually that contains the 43% of the lipid and 49% of the protein. The rest of the part is the carbohydrates. And many other small amount of the things they are present. And coming to the mouse liver cell, that contains the 49% of lipid and 46% of the lipid and 54% of the proteins. So, in this way, the protein content may vary from the cell to the cell, which are present in the different kinds of the organs and different kinds of the tissues also. So, in this way, the differentiation only between the plasma membrane is the content which are present in the protein and lipid ratio. So, this is a very important point to be noted. And coming to the next point. So, these plasma membrane, actually, where the plasma membrane structure was discovered completely. Actually, the complete structural features of plasma membrane is invented after the invention of the microscope that is called as an electron microscope. Electron microscope in the 1950s, electron microscope was invented. After invention of this microscope, the complete structure of the plasma membrane was studied, and finally in the 1972, Singer and Nicholson or the scientists, they observed the plasma membrane under the electron microscope and postulated a model structure that is called as a fluid mosaic model. Before this fluid mosaic model, there are many models they postulated by the many scientists, but in the present situation, we accepting this fluid mosaic model, that is postulated by the Singer and Nicholson. These two sciences also very important. So this fluid mosaic model is very acceptable in present day. We are using and we are studying this fluid mosaic model. So let us see what is the fluid mosaic model which is postulated by the Singer and Nicholson. Actually, Singer and Nicholson postulated the fluid mosaic model, that is, plasma membrane is a quasi quasi model in which the proteins which are present in the lipid layer, whereas lipids are the fluid in nature. It means the lipid which present as a fluid, in the fluid structure, the proteins present in the, or proteins embedded or inserted into the lipid layer, but it's not completely occupied entire lipid layer. In some very little places, these proteins are occupied into the lipid layer, such type of model which is called as a fluid mosaic model. So let us see what is the structure of plasma membrane which is present in the fluid mosaic model, and also what are the components which are present in the fluid mosaic model. So fluid mosaic model. So let us draw what is the structure of the plasma membrane. This is called as a plasma membrane. So you can see here, this is the structure of plasma membrane of fluid mosaic model. Here the names which are indicating that, here these are the sugars or saccharides or carbohydrates, and this is called as a peripheral protein. And this is the integral protein. And these two called as a lipid layers. Lipid layers. And you can just assume this is the internal part. And this one is the external part of cell. External part and also internal part of the cell. Let us see. Actually, what are the components which are present in the plasma membrane? The plasma membrane that contains the lipids and also contains the proteins and also contains the carbohydrates and also contains the sterols. You just write here the sterols. These are the structural components present in the plasma membrane. Let us start with the lipids. Actually, in the plasma membrane, most of the lipids are the phospholipids. Generally, the lipids that contains a skeletal structure, you can see here, alcohol, phosphate, and another alcohol, fatty acids, two fatty acids. This is the skeletal structure of any lipid. Let us see what is the phospholipid. Actually, the lipid that contains the phosphate, that is called as the phospholipid. Here the alcohol is two types. At this place, the alcohol is present in two types, that is called as a glycerol and sphingosine. Glycerol and sphingosine. Let us start with the glycerol. Here is a glycerol that is called as a glycerophospholipid. Glycerophospholipid. This glycerophospholipid that contains the two fatty acids and also one alcohol, that is the glycerol, one phosphate. Here the alcohol is replaced. Alcohol is replaced by the moieties, alcoholic moieties such as choline and serine. So the glycerol lipids again divide into two types based on the alcohol here present. That is, if choline is present, that is the glycerophospholipids, that is called as a phosphatidyl choline. If this alcohol is replaced by the serine, that is called as a phosphatidyl serine. Phosphatidyl serine. You can see the phospholipids are the two types, glycerophospholipids, sphingophospholipids. In the plasma membrane, most probably glycerophospholipids are the more abundant than the sphingophospholipids. This is a very important. Glycerophospholipids are the more abundant. Among the glycerophospholipids like phosphatidyl choline and phosphatidyl serine, the phosphatidyl choline is a more abundant in the plasma membrane. More abundant in the plasma membrane. This is also very important. If they ask the which one of the components which is more abundant in among the phospholipids, you have to choose the glycerophospholipids. And if there is options in the glycerophospholipids like phosphatidyl choline and phosphatidyl serine, you can choose, the correct answer is the phosphatidyl choline. Okay, this is the more important. After the glycerophospholipids, sphingolipids also present. In these sphingolipids, this alcohol place is replaced by this sphingosine, that is called as the sphingophospholipids. Sphingophospholipids. These sphingophospholipids, this alcohol place is replaced by the myelin. So, such type of sphingophospholipid called as the sphingomyelin. This sphingomyelin is more abundant in the sphingolipids, especially the sphingophospholipids. So, this is all about the what? Phospholipids and their structure. What are the abundant components present in the plasma membrane? Here you have to understand, you can see this is called as a structure, knob-like structure called as head. And this is the tail. You can see such same structure observing here. This is called as head. And these are the tails. It means the head that exposing outside and also that exposing internal side. This is also head. The head that exposing outside and also that exposing internal of the plasma membrane or internal of the cell. So, this head actually that contains a property called as a hydrophilic. And these are the tails that contains a property called as a hydrophobic. Here, the hydrophobic nature of the plasma membrane lipids, especially phospholipids or the fatty acids, hydrophilic nature of the phospholipids are the these part, alcohol, phosphate and alcohol. So, this is called as a head and tail like structures. This tail like structure in a single layer, layer 1 and another layer, layer 2. So, two layers are adjacent to each other, they forms the lipid bilayer. Lipid bilayer. This lipid bilayer, this hydrophobic nature and hydrophilic nature, both natures are present in the lipids, such type of plasma membrane called as a amphipathic nature. Amphipathic nature means both hydrophobic and hydrophilic. Then what is the hydrophobic and what is the hydrophilic? Hydrophobic, it means the water haters. It means the components which doesn't dissolve in the water, such type of components called as a hydrophobic. Coming to the hydrophilic. Hydrophilic in the sense the components which completely dissolved in the water, such type of components called as a hydrophilic. Here, these groups, alcohol and phosphate or alcohols, these groups are hydrophilic in nature. That means they persist and they present in the water side. These are the components that are present in the tail or the fatty acid. They doesn't dissolve in the water. You know very well, oils and some fats that they are doesn't dissolve in the water. You can just observe, if you take a drop of oil into the water, you can observe the droplets on the surface of water. Because the droplets of oil cannot dissolve in the water. At the same time, you can choose a polysaccharide, that is a sugar, that dissolved in the completely in the water. Such type of components called as a hydrophilic. Due to the hydrophilic nature of the sugars, they dissolved in the water. Due to the hydrophobic nature in the oils, they doesn't dissolve in the water. This is the most important. You can see why they arranged like this. See, the outside of the plasma membrane that contains the hydrophilic moieties, that means there is a water. And inside of the cell that contains the cytoplasm, cytoplasm also that contains the hydrophilic moieties. Hydrophilic moieties like water. So, the hydrophilic nature of the these phospholipids towards the internal structure and towards the outer external structure. Whereas, fatty acids are the hydrophobic nature. They are towards the internal of the plasma membrane. So, in this way, the plasma membrane can adjust and forms the cell. These are the lipids. These are the complete structure of the lipids and what are the abundant structures which are present in the lipids. Coming to the proteins. We know very well here I draw the protein. Proteins actually, they are present in the plasma membrane divided into two types. One is the peripheral protein, another is the embedded protein that is called as the integral proteins. The proteins that contains the hydrophobic nature, the proteins that contains the hydrophobic nature and also hydrophilic nature, that is called an amphipathic nature of the protein. Hydrophobic nature means hydrophobic amino acids which are present in the proteins. Such proteins are embedded into the hydrophobic nature of the plasma membrane. This is the entirely hydrophobic nature. This hydrophobic nature that contains the plasma membrane, the proteins called as integral proteins. Integral proteins, why they are integrated into the plasma membrane? Because such proteins contains the hydrophobic amino acid side chains. So, they are embedded. Coming to the second type, peripheral proteins. Peripheral proteins are the proteins that doesn't involve in depth of the plasma membrane. Such proteins called as the peripheral proteins. These peripheral proteins, integral proteins are the two types of proteins that are present in the plasma membrane. So, here also peripheral proteins. Okay, these proteins. And these proteins also contains the some sugars. These proteins also contains the some sugars. Such proteins called as a glycoproteins. Such proteins called as a glycoprotein. It means the proteins that contains the sugar moieties. Such both. A name called as a glycoproteins. We know very well RBCs, in the sense red blood cells. We know very well different kinds of blood groups are there, like A blood group, B blood group, AB and O blood group. Here, the antibodies, they are the glycoproteins. The antibodies, they are the glycoproteins. So, the glycoproteins, it means the proteins that combined with the sugar moieties. The proteins that combined with the sugar moieties, glycoproteins are the antibodies. These antibodies present on the RBC cell surface. For example, A blood group that contains the B antibody. B blood group that contains the A antibodies like that. In this way, the proteins that associated with the sugars, such proteins called as a glycoproteins. So, RBC cells that contains the glycoproteins as antibodies. And coming to the carbohydrates. There are many type of carbohydrates. The carbohydrates which are attached to the proteins and which are also attached to the lipids. If the carbohydrates attached to the lipids, such type of lipids called as a glycolipids. If the lipids are carbohydrate attached to the proteins, that such type of proteins called as a glycoproteins. So, this length of the carbohydrates may vary from cell to cell and also within the cell, because a protein that contains a large carbohydrate length and also short carbohydrate length. A lipid that contains a large carbohydrate length and also short carbohydrate length. The length is differ from within the cell and also differ from the cell to the cell. This is called as a carbohydrates. Coming to the sterols. Sterols are the very short amount that are present in the plasma membrane. Actually, we know very well sterols that contains the four ring structures. Four ring structures. These four ring structures, three are the six carbon ring and one is the five carbon ring. You just see the structure of sterols. This is the 1, 2, 3. Three are the six carbon member rings, and this one is the five carbon member. You can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this is called as a sterols. In the actually animal plasma membrane, animals plasma membrane, the sterols which present in the animal plasma membrane is the cholesterol. Is the cholesterol. Cholesterols are the sterols which are only present in the animals. These cholesterols that doesn't present in the plant and also some bacteria. Doesn't present in the plants and bacteria. It means cholesterol is a more important aspect for the neat purposes. Because the very peculiar point, cholesterol, which one of the following is doesn't present in the all of the plasma membrane. All of the plasma membranes of animals, plants and also bacteria. So that is the question. Then they give the options lipids, proteins, carbohydrates and cholesterol. The answer, peculiar answer is the cholesterol. That's why we have to stress on this concept. Cholesterol which are present in the only animal cell. And this cholesterol doesn't present in the plant and also any bacteria except mycoplasma. Mycoplasma that contains the cholesterol. Okay, this is all about the sterols, carbohydrates, proteins and lipids which are present in the plasma membrane of the fluid mosaic model which is postulated by the Singer and Nicholson in the year of 1972. Okay, it is clear. So, in this way, this plasma membrane is arranged due to the many reasons and there is a selective permeability is left and there is a fluidity also left. I will discuss this fluidity of the plasma membrane and also selective permeability of the plasma membrane and transport system which are present in the plasma membrane in the next class. Thank you. If you really like this video, please do subscribe my channel HSR Bioinfo. Don't forget to subscribe and like, share, comment. Thank you.